out 10th and final amateur fight of the night. Co-main event up next between King and Guzman. But now it's all about Mitchell and Duran. We are underway with our 10th fight here at AKA 19. Footwork here early on.
Yeah, he's swapping up the stance is pretty good. And also, yeah, it's a lot of moving.
Tell him to bring it on. I got a feeling this is going to be a banger. Finally, some action here. It's Durant looking for the kick.
It's a good leg kick. Missed that one.
Step out of range there, loads up for a right hand, misses, but he'll end up on top.
Now, Duran's out of Grayson United, so we expect him to have some decent jiu-jitsu off his back here.
So trying to slip that left leg through. Over a minute 40 seconds here for Mitchell to work, but Duran trying to reverse it, and both back of their feet.
Mitchell's trying to dig right here for a takedown. Good little shoulder bump there, getting back to where he wanted his hooks at. Doing a good job of mixing up the strikes to kind of try to get in a different position. You see him lunging that shoulder again.
Trying to soften him up a little bit here so he can look for that takedown.
Even some rabbit punches to the leg. I mean, whatever it takes.
That one looked like it might have slipped right up the middle. Another takedown here for
Mitchell. A lot of muscle there, not so much technique, but hey, it worked.
Mitchell back on top for the second time in the first round. 50 seconds to work.
Where you get in trouble too, because he has that arm trapped under his leg. Mitchell does, and
fortunately, be
dangerous. Durant, good job of coming out there though.
Well, for Durant, it's gonna be the end of the round here. Not as much action as you might have expected, but we may end with a couple of punches there from Durant.
I like it.
Takedown by Benton Mitchell seems to be the biggest moment of that round.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot of action.
Well, they're both loosened up now. We'll see what comes in the second.
Saw early on Mitchell changing stances, showing a lot of different things to Duran. Ended up on top two different times, but Duran doing a good job of scrambling, staying out of any real danger. Good stuff here at AKA 19. Don't forget, we're two fights away from our championship fight tonight between David Bosnick and Dakota Hope. The AKA featherweight title is up for grabs. Who will grab glory here at AKA 19? Can Bosnick defend his title? He took it away from Lauren Thibodeau back at AKA 17. That was actually supposed to be a fight between Lauren Thibodeau and Dakota Hope. And
yeah, Bosnick something happened last minute. I believe it was a COVID-19 issue or something, now that I remember. But yes, Bosnick stepped in, took the title, and now Hope's got a shot at it.
And Hope back where he belonged the first time. Round two coming up here between Duran and Mitchell. See what adjustments are made as we move into the second. Duran. Mitchell kind of laughed that one off.
Duran's done a good job. Oh, that was different and pretty. I liked it. Duran's done a good job of staying on that lead leg, too. Mitchell's going to do it now.
Both guys having some fun out there, showing off some unique techniques. Got to be careful with some of that.
Yeah,
you
I mean, you really do. You really do. Mitchell just hugged him up and did a hell of a takedown right there.
Benton Mitchell, very strong. Seems showcasing the strength there. And once again, he's back on top.
Yeah, now we're going to see Duran, you know, make a lot of movement here. We'll see what he goes for and if Mitchell can advance.
Mitchell trying to do some damage with the right. Similar to the first.
Yeah, Mitchell doing a good job on top of just, you know, grinding away, dropping punches where needed, keeping Duran from, you know, making any major transitions, staying heavy on him.
Mitchell needs a few shots there. Duran, you gotta start to find a way up to your feet at some point, maybe try and push off here, but not yet.
Can't throw those at the amateur level. Sorry. We'll catch them on the last two fights, though. I'm sure there'll be some flying.
We'll see some elbows once we move into the professional ranks.
I mean, he's doing a good job of, you know, steadily controlling and throwing strikes. It's not like we're just laying here at this point, you know. Well, just drag him against the cage and see what he does here.
He's found small ways to score some points here in this second round. Obviously, he's been in control the whole time from the top.
Yeah.
15 seconds remaining in round two. We've seen the entire round essentially with Mitchell on top. Trying to score a little bit more. Left hand lands as we conclude round number two. Vince Mitchell's so strong, he showcased the string multiple times, just really unable for Duran to find any way out from underneath the pressure of Vince Mitchell.
Yeah, there's multiple times where he just showcased pure strength and, you know, not so much technicality, but it worked. It's working for him now. You know, at this point, if he's, you know, we're going to see where it lands, but, you know, last round, he was really just in the guard, controlling, throwing punches from there. Probably should have postured up and tried to finish it that way, but, you know, hey. Still a good display.
Seemingly Vince Mitchell ahead 2-0 through the first two rounds. You know, we had Mitchell way back at AKA 14, that was a victory over Yosef Morales.
Let's cut that shit out. You paid the C-Pikes, not Star-Pikes, guys. Let's sit down, cool it down a little bit.
Sounds like maybe we have something going on outside of the cage here between a couple of fans. You know.
Hey, man, it happens.
You hope it doesn't happen, but always people get, you know, the alcohol starts flowing, and they get excited. We've seen it happen with many events across the country, not here, just here at AKA.
Yeah.
But right now it's back to the action in the cage. Mitchell.
Right, so right now we're pretty evened up. No one's threw a significant shot yet.
And there really hasn't been any big punches landed so far in this fight. It's all been dictated by Mitchell on the ground. And that's, you can hear the corner of Duran, like, you've got to throw punches.
Yeah,
you've got to throw
something. Yeah, you got to do something at this point. You definitely have to let something go here.
Really, the only shot that we've seen was kind of that right hand early on in round number two from Mitchell.
He threw some effective leg kicks, too. Other than that, we haven't seen a lot of striking from him. He was coming out of a Gracie camp, you'd expect, you know, more jiu-jitsu than anything.
Mitchell threw a big right there, missed it, and pushed Duran up against the cage. Way through round number three. Mitchell once again controlling the pace here in another round.
Mitch were doing a good job in the clinch of mixing it up with strikes. You know, knee, you know, foot stomp.
And making it dirty.
You know, moving his shoulders, shrugging, you know, just going for another, like I said, not so much of a technical takedown, more muscle, but hey, you made it work, you know.
And a takedown's a takedown.
That's right, that's
and
right.
Once again, Benton Mitchell back on top. So you have to get up here. They know he's in real trouble with 1 minute to go.
At this point now, there's just not much, you know, to help outscore Mitchell in this round, unless you set up a, you know, a submission. But that's then again, you know, about the third round, both fighters usually have a lot of sweat too. You know, securing a submission after the first round is just always a lot more complicated.
Inside 30 seconds to go in our final round. Mitchell could pick up his fourth win here tonight.
No, no, it's not at this point. You know, he's just hanging on at this point. Ben Mitchell's going to finish this out in a dominant position.
Well, just as he's been for much of this fight, Ben Mitchell in that dominant position. And that is how the third and final round ends. Impressive showing here from Ben Mitchell. Didn't really get a chance to see a whole lot on the feet from either guy because Mitchell took it to the ground and controlled it from there. Baby Gorilla showing off that strength.
We definitely know how he got his nickname.
Ready for a, you know, sometimes you got to hit a quick pose after you just had a good fight, too.
Of course.
But Benton Mitchell really, really was impressive in this one. Never was in any kind of danger throughout the entire fight. And finished each round on top. We missed danger. Dynamite back into the cage. Gonna find out who the winner is here between Duran and Mitchell.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of fantastic mixed martial arts action, we are going to the judges' scorecard. Ladies and gentlemen, all three judges have seen and scored this fight the same way, therefore declaring your winner by unanimous decision, fighting in the blue corner, Benton Mitchell!
Well, there you have it. Benton Mitchell picks up his fourth win in the cage here tonight at AKA 19. And that wraps up our amateur fights. What a great round of amateur fights. Every single fight outside of one goes the distance,
man. DJ. It's been definitely some well-matched fights, some great bouts. And, I mean, I've been impressed with this amateur card, man.